Welcome to my video on some sort of hacks on how to use Google Maps when you're going abroad on holiday. This is mainly sort of focused on the Orlando, but this will work for anywhere where you're away. Now, I know what you're thinking, Google Maps uses your data all the time, but what you can actually do, a lot of people don't know, is you can store what's called offline maps, which means it actually stores all of the map data on your phone, and then you can use it without an internet connection. So what you have to do is you navigate to around the area you want. So I've just typed in Orlando, Florida at the top there. You close that down. You click on your face. This only works on local devices, on phones and things. Click on offline maps. Click select your own map. And then try and find, now you can zoom out a little bit if you want to. Try and get more data in. And it tells you at the bottom how much data you're going to use on your phone. So this, if I grab this area here, which gets into the Sanford area and further down in Kissimmee, St. Cloud and so on, it takes up 120 meg of your free space. So if you click download, it starts downloading. So while that's downloading, you can click on it, click on the little pencil icon and rename it. So I'm going to call this Orlando. Save. So you can leave that chugging away downloading. So that's a really, really handy feature. It means you can use the maps without having to use your data while you're abroad, which is great. You can also top these things up a little bit better while you're away as well, once you're using the Wi-Fi in the hotels. So that's a really great feature to use. Now, another good feature that a lot of people don't sort of properly know about, this is really great for when you're traveling from Orlando International Airport, because the standard route that they give you at every place really when you rent a car is it takes you via a toll road, which is the beach line, or used to be called the B line, but it's now the beach line expressway. They're not expensive tolls, maybe $1.25, $1.75 and so on, but usually you have to stop at a booth because invariably you won't have change with you. And it can take a bit of time. So one of the really good features is if you click on the airport, you click on the directions button, and then you click on the two arrows up the right there to reverse the direction. So you're going from Orlando International Airport. Now, one of the hotels I found was on American Way on International Drive. So I type in at the bottom there American Way, or I find it on my list. Now, you have these icons at the top. First one gives you the driving directions. Now you can see here that there's avoiding tolls. There's some options you can use here, so you can set it to avoid motorways, tolls or ferries. I always tick the avoid tolls, and finds us the best route. So if you look here, this is the airport here. So you're coming out of the airport here. Usually you'll be coming from by this icon, by the Starbucks. You'll be coming from the car rental places. You'll come up this road here, get into the right hand lane, and then you'll be looking for a turn off called Cargo Road. So you'll come off to the right here. You'll come down, you'll turn right onto Cargo Road. You'll follow Cargo Road along. You'll eventually get to a place called Bear Road, where you turn right onto Bear Road. You follow that up, it takes you around the airport, and then it takes you, you can see the Beach Line Expressway there, it takes you parallel to the Beach Line. Come back down there then on Bear Road, and then you turn right onto Tradeport Drive, and then you come up Tradeport Drive, and then you turn left then, and you're getting onto McCoy Road, it's called, which eventually becomes Sand Lake Road. So we'll scroll along here, and you'll pass some interesting places along here, and there's an Aldi along here on the right as well, if you're familiar with that from the UK. As you carry on along, you'll get to the Florida Mall, so it sort of gives you a bit of the lay of the land as well. And then you'll get a, see this Florida Mall here, Florida Mall Avenue and so on. And then further along, when we get to this place here, so this Dollar Tree and so on, that has a McDonald's, and there's a massive Walmart here as well by this Lowe's Home Improvement. Keep following this road along here, and you'll eventually get to Kirkland Road, and then up there, and then you're onto International Drive here. There's International Drive, you turn left there, and then you got onto American Way. Now, it says it takes about half an hour, which is usually about right, depending on traffic. They do say that if you avoid tolls. So if you don't avoid tolls and you go along the beach line, it'll only take you 20 to 25 minutes. But that's as if there's no hold up at the tolls. I always find there's hold up at the toll booths, so it doesn't actually save you that much time going that way, and it's a lot of faffing because you've usually the smallest you've got, if you've got currency from this country, is $20, and you have to faff about. There's also a lot of rental cars do these things called Sun Pass, which allows you to drive through the Sun Pass lane, but there's an extra charge for that. They charge, I think, $7.50 for every day that you use it, and then they add the tolls on as well, and then they charge you at the end of the rental. So I always try and avoid tolls if I can, and that works really well, especially on offline maps, so you'll find that. There's other really good features here with Google Maps, as well as driving directions. You'll see up here there's an icon which looks like a bus or a train. If you click on that, you can actually see how you'd be able to get from the airport just on public transport. You can see here there's a route, bus 42. It takes an hour and a minute, so it's double the time, but it only costs $2 per person because it's a direct route. So if you click on that, you'll see this is the route here. You can get at it and you can get the bus directly on the airport there, called Quick Turnaround Boulevard, I think it is. And then you carry on down there, and shows you all of the roads. There's a lot of stops, and that's why it takes so long. But it's a really direct route then. It takes you out and up and round and along, and then you eventually get near to American Way as you come along here. Brings you down International Drive, and there you are. So and then you have to get out left there and walk. So it's a really, really, really good way of doing it. That's the public transport, and that'll work for any route that you want to get onto. You've also along here got, obviously you're not going to walk it, but you've got rideshare services. So you click on this guy here, which is a guy with his hand up, and you can see here it uses Lyft. So you can see at the moment it's saying there's a 9 minute wait, but there is actually, you can see the Lyft car on there. There is a car already at the airport, and these are indicative costs for each one. So if there's a lot of you, if there's only two of you, you can usually get the basic one, but if there's a lot of you and a lot of luggage, you need the XL or the Lux. So can cost you a fair bit of money that to get there, but again, it'll be roughly the same amount of time as if you were driving it. So that sort of thing is really useful for getting around while you're in Orlando. Hope that's been helpful. If you do like this this video, then please subscribe and put a like on it so that I know to make more if people like it. Thanks very much for listening.